G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today I'm looking at Soldier and the Beggar's Bazooka. I'm going to be using the Beggar's Bazooka, and I'm going to switch it up between the Shotgun or the Righteous Bison, and I'm also going to use the Escape Plan to try and get out of there. So starting this round, we're on bad water, and I'd like to try and keep a hold of the high ground. I thought I had killed that medic there, so when I turned the corner saw the medic had Uber, I knew I was in a bad spot. I don't know if there was anywhere to run there. So yeah, I'm finding I like this rocket launcher. It's a different style. I prefer it on defense. But I definitely like to have a reserve weapon. I don't like carrying the buff banner or some of the other, you know, the conch shell or whatever it is. Because I find when you're up close and personal or it's a really long distance shot, you know, the 5% spread isn't going to help you out. Had some Gerardi on me here, so I had to watch myself. Don't know what happened to that medic there, looks like he might have lagged up. So thanks to DrAdniac for giving me a heal here. Had a couple pockets, was totally not expecting a sentry gun there. Well, let's take a look up top, I like keeping a height advantage. Forget what's up front, I don't want this medic around, and somehow I completely avoided the side of that heavy. But the medic escaped. Oh well. Now I've got a medic to mean a heavy to deal with up top here. But he's dead before I get there. But they popped the cap. Bazooka easily able to take care of the scout. Let's not have that sentry gun. Oh, and criticals. Criticals on this weapon are lovely. You get so many of them, or it seems like so many of them, because each shot is actually counting for three, so it seems to happen more often. It's not impossible to rocket jump, but as I was going for a rocket jump there, I noticed a spy, and I play spy often enough to know where he's probably gonna go. Sure enough, he's right here. Probably should have changed out to my shotgun a little earlier, but you know, the engineer was able to take care of the sap. Loading up my shots before dropping down. Just keeping an eye on the payload. Gotta watch pyros with this weapon. Pyros actually love seeing soldiers with this weapon because of the 5% spread, they're already a little inaccurate. But with the three rockets, you got so much to reflect. See, not hard to rocket jump, you just gotta time it a bit better. Takes a little bit of getting used to. But I find the major issue is running out of ammo. You gotta stay with your ammo supplies, you gotta stay supplied a lot. I also have trouble with getting the ammo off of the payload, and you'll see that later. Dealing with a pyro here, so I switch out to my shotgun. But you know, I'm on a slow burn and the healing is gone, so... phew! I ain't that lucky. But I'm still low on health. And looking back over this replay, you know what? I would have been better off dying. All this time I'm taking to go on back and get healing, it's not worth it. I would have been respawned by now. Okay, so they're moving in. Charge up a shot before you come around the corner. See, that was completely in the blind. I had no idea someone was coming, I was just expecting them to be there. Much like you'd get a shot with the Huntsman or a couple of other weapons where you kind of preemptively shoot where you expect the enemy to be. And you'll see each time I shoot, I kind of back up after the shot because I know, you know, I'm going to be exposed for a little bit while I'm waiting for the next shot to load up. Taking a shot of that medic, but you see the glitched icon on top of that heavy? I was expecting to do a lot more damage to that heavy. That's from the gloves of running urgently, but it seems to have been glitched up or people have found a way to glitch it. Starting to run low on ammo here. You run through ammo very fast, but you know, score the medic. And shadows. I hate shadows in the game, especially as a spy. I mean, I knew where that sniper was just by the shadow I was seeing on the ground. It's so dang annoying. As a spy, I never know where my shadow is, but sometimes enemies are able to come around the corner and take care of me because they've seen my shadow. See, I know they've got a teleporter up there, and this pyro gets a reflect. Dang it, that hurts. Alright, have to back up. Let my team know about the teleporter. Take a few moments to load up. Reheal, restock. I hear the mini sentry, but I don't see anything, so it must have been the scout. Get a few misses on the scout, but then I pop him up in the air and the sentry finishes him off. Always, I'm always aiming for people's feet as a soldier, because you want to bounce them, you want to juggle them. But you know, I had a pyro in front of me here, doing what I can. Cloverleaf's telling me he's ready to go, so I start loading up, and let's see what we can do about this encampment up here. Running low on ammo, but he pops the uber, so what I do is I overstock the gun, and when you overstock the gun, you hold 3 shots, but then you start exploding them on yourself. And while you're in uber, I mean, that's so much fun to do. Just take that mess down. So yeah, medics, if you see a soldier with the Beggar's Bazooka and they look like they have half a clue, be watching for that. When you're close to uber, they might be overcharging their shots. You know, anticipating the uber. Yeah, we might have taken their stuff down, but I'm checking to make sure it's not back up. Because last I checked, they might have still had their teleport up, I wasn't sure. I overstuck a little there to damage myself, just so I can help him build uber. But again, there's that glitched icon. I did the one overcharged shot, so I'd explode it straight on him. And then tried to kill him with the 3 shots, but you know, he was glitched, so I was expecting to do a lot more damage. I see the scout here, but I fire my rockets at the health pack that he was going to go and try and rush to. So the enemy's slowly moving up, but we're holding a pretty good defense. It's very hard to get those low angle shots on enemies. I always want to take the high ground as a soldier. Be shooting down so you can juggle them or get the splash damage on them. Trying to anticipate where the enemy's gonna be. Saw a sniper trail, but I wasn't expecting this nice of a shot coming from that sniper. Check out this. Down to 1 ammo. When you're on 1, or if you're on 3 or less, you actually hold that shot forever. And you'll see that later. I have some good footage of that. Spy gets a backstab on that heavy weapons. So we're able to move out. There's Dr. Adniac, and Cloverleaf is pocketing me at the moment. But what a nice shot. Nice shot from the sniper there, but it looks like our spy was right behind him. He had a razor back, but I don't expect that to live long. Following the beam here, I don't want that medic to be staying around. I'll concentrate my fire on medics all day long. But you know, with the Beggar's Bazooka, use the corner a lot. Ow, Crockett. Crockett knocking me back. Picking up health, picking up ammo. Managed to overload the bazooka there. But Cloverleaf's close to an uber, so you know, let's do this. I'll overcharge my Zooka and move in. We'll try and do the same thing as before. But dang it, he didn't pop it in time. Oh well, he popped it on the, let's see, he popped it on an engineer and the engineer moved out. Still pushed the heavy back, still did the job. You know, I'm not like some other players who are really, really particular about their health or how many times they've died. I'm more interested in the team objectives. Like here, we're in the last few moments. I'm in a tricky situation, but I want their teleporter down, so I move in and take out the sentry. With the sentry down, the rest of my team was able to take out their teleport. With their teleport down, they didn't have too many to push with, and we were able to manage this. Look at that. Using the payload as a shield. And that's this round. So on defense, yeah, I really like the Beggar's Bazooka. I mean, you're expecting enemies to be in certain places. On offense, not so much. You don't get the high ground as much. I switched out here from the shotgun to the Righteous Bison, because with the 5% spread on the bazooka, I was having trouble hitting far targets, so I thought, you know what, the Bison tends to have a pretty straight shot, even though it's not as much damage. I sell out my life here to get rid of the engineer. With the engineer down, our team was easily able to take down that sentry gun. I actually commented, why didn't a spy move in and sap the gun? Please, cloak and dagger spies, please don't just watch the world burn. Damaging myself a little here. Wanting to help build the Uber, but I was not expecting the heavy to pop around the corner. So coming out of spawn, I see the pyro is picking on this spy. But you know, I don't like spies just like the rest of them. Concentrate some fire on that pyro, and because I don't have distance shot on the Zooka, you know, use the Bison to try and get that demo man. But you'll see here, I'm loading up the bazooka in the tunnel, and I did not get any ammo from the payload. This happens a few times. I'm gonna have to check the wiki on why I'm not getting a load off of the payload. Or if you guys know, you know, add it to the comments. Maybe I'm just being lazy. It's just something I noticed. With the 5% spread, my bazooka was not doing much to that sentry gun. People are saying, you know, the bazooka's great for taking out sentries, but, you know, with the spread, you have to get really close to do that, and if you've been close to a sentry gun... So, you know, I went to my Righteous Bison here, and the other soldier was able to approach me. Soldier up close against my Bison, not much good. So I spot that Your Eternal Reward spy at spawn. Gonna have to keep your eyes on stuff like that. I didn't think he was dead, and I see him again. He's trying to get a stair stab or something here. And I'm totally not convinced that I've killed that spy. Not convinced. And I see him again down here. Yep, there he is. Unusual hats. Floating yellow bubble kind of helped me see that. I'm going to be doing a talk soon on what I think of hats. Watch out for stickies. So yeah, falling back to my my secondary weapon here for these distance shots against a sniper. You know, and the Bison's good for that. It's a little bit spammy. Let's go. But you know what? I have a really bad time, you know, pushing a payload with this. I don't know. I kind of want to stay back because it's... I don't know, it's not as reliable as your regular rocket launchers. That 5% spread can really hurt you. So you'll see, they're pushing the payload and I'm kind of supporting them instead. Instead of being up front and central like a soldier should be. So I go for the high ground here, reloading my weapon. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, we can take out that stuff with the Zooka. And I was going to go for those snipers, but right as I went to approach them, you know, they got a mini sentry, and I had to fire on that, using up all my rounds. Anyway, I was able to capitalize on that. So moving back in. Yeah, that was a spy. I don't expect that I killed him. Kind of following the trail where I'd expect the spy to be. Let my team know there's a spy around. I'm not sure I've killed him, and sure enough I come back here and what do I see? Well, actually I thought I'd see him a little bit earlier, but there he is. Ah! Totally not surprised. Got the sap on, but I also don't know if he got away. He had plenty of time to go get ammo. Yep, there he is. Picked up the engineer. Oh well. He's faster than I am. I couldn't chase him down. Having a quick look at our team loadout. Juggling the pyro with those single shots. You know, it's all about timing. After a little while you get really used to the timing, and I kinda like this weapon. But what I find you lose... Oh, that was a no-scope shot from that sniper. But what I find that you lose is the ability to...